Hi there. Today we're going to be having a look at a brand new release from Sonoff. This is the Zigbee Mini R2. It's a Zigbee Mini relay which can be used with two switches. Comparing this device with an ESP32 just gives you an idea of the size of this device, and it does contain a 10 amp relay. So having a look at the front of the casing, we've got a button here for pairing. We've got a little LED over here which will give us the status either in the pairing mode or showing us whether it's connected to the Zigbee network. We've got two neutral lines. We've got a live in and a live out. And then we've got a switch one and a switch two, which does offer us that dual switching ability. So the Zigbee Mini R2 does require a neutral wire. It does perform as a router with Zigbee 3.0 and has up to 64 sub-devices. It does allow for external switching as well as showing the power on state. And then it's got this thing called the detached relay mode, which apparently means that you can detach the switch so that the switching ability of the local switch will not affect the relay. So when wiring this device, always remember to switch off your power at the breaker before you start, and do get a qualified electrician to do this for you. So we've got two options here. We can either connect it with a single switch, which would be connected between S1 and S2. In that case, we would bring the live in over here. The live would then go out to the light, and the light would return to the neutral. We would then also bring neutral power into this section over here. Now, if we want to do a dual switching, all we do is we have our two switches, one going to each one of these two, S1 and S2. To add this to the Sonoff app, we press the plus button, we go scan, we scan the QR code, we go add device, next. Now what we do is we long press the button for 5 seconds, let it start flashing, then we go next, we go yes. And now we select the device that we want to connect it to this. So I'm using the NS Panel Pro, so we'll just select that over there. There we go, it's discovered it. We go next, and there we go. Our device is all linked up to EWELink. Now that we've got it in the EWELink app, we can control it, and we can also go in there and we can set up things like schedules, timers, or even loop timers. Now we also can connect this directly to Home Assistant. I am using my SM Lite, so I'm just going to go add integration, Zigbee device, and you'll see it popping up. There we go, easy as that, and we'll just put it in the kitchen. There we go. We can now go back and we can find our Zigbee Mini. There it is over there. So we've got access to the switch. And we've also got access to the sensor. So that's the input of the switch going into the device. Down here, we've got two entities. So we could check out the signal strength if we wanted to. And we can also go in, then we can select return to state, on, off, toggle, or previous value if the power is switched off. So that's all for now. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.